And we're back with another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG Chick, as always, here with episode 21. I have actually not played this game for a month. Not out of choice, really. I've been dying to play it. I've just been trying to keep up with all the other games I've had on my channel, and some of them, the editing has been a little insane. So we're over that hump, pretty much, and as you notice, may notice on the bottom here, we've upgraded to the new version. It's patch 2.2.0.5, which for some reason corresponds with version 1.0.5.0567. Okay. It's good to me. There are options. There are new options, mostly fixing a lot of bugs, and you can actually change the voice and character, the portrait picture of your character now in this update, which is good because I really do not like the voice for our new protagonist, Firebrand. So, sorry for anyone who likes her evil voice. I'll be changing that because I just want to punch her in the face every time I hear her talk. I'm sorry. So, options. There is some new stuff under graphics, believe it or not. Graphics quality. This was not here before. So, of course, I pumped that one all the way up. I'm not sure what the quality was previously because the setting wasn't even there. When I started the game up, it was right here in the middle. And you've got three settings, obviously. So we have it cranked up, and frame rate, this was already set to max. It's a little misleading, in which case you'd think that max is here, like they're showing you this is max, but yeah. That's it. Everything else, as far as I can tell, is the same. Still have my arrows, yep. I think I changed those. Auto pause. I removed a few things, didn't I? Yeah. I took this out. Not sure. Maybe I took one of these out as well. So, okay. That is it. For as far as I can tell. Yep. Okay. Loading that. Good. That's actually not bad at all. One of the things I noticed when I first changed these settings and left, you know, went to load the game, is that the loading screen took a long time. So I might, you know, if I remember, I might still edit that. You know, chop that out a little bit. But we are pretty much done here, although we owe a rematch to the king, the Scolder King, down in the Temple of Eothas. But when we get a few more levels and get some more party members possibly as well. Going back to the Valewood, because we have not explored that area, and we do owe a rematch to those bandits. And I think the person that they had was the chef from the Black Hound Inn, if I remember the name right. We are... okay. Not sure why I did that. Okay. Yeah, they're over here somewhere. Oh, wait. Yeah, this side of the bridge. So I might be a little rusty with my skills, forgive me. I haven't played for quite some time. Eager to get back into it, not with, not with this episode, but in a couple days we're going to be going daily with this game, so I'll be able to make a lot more tracks, play it a lot more, and I'll be happy. And a touch more salt. How long does it take to make some damn stew? Hail! I could have surprised them. I know they're not friendly, but that's not fair because that was, well, I guess it was a nightmare she had of, you know, being killed by bandits because it never actually happened, i.e. in real-world terms, reloaded. The young dwarf tending to the stew looks up, startled as he sees your approach. He drops his ladle, spattering stew across the ground. What? The bandit turns. Get her, you dogs, and make sure our new cook don't run off. It is. It's Tenfrith from the Black Hound Inn. Help! Please help me! Ah! One of the bandits gives Tenfrith a kick as they pass him, and he huddles. Don't rush me! You have to let the meat absorb the flavor. I think they've got their eyes on this meat right now. Right. Stuff up here. Alright. Well, if I remember right, her spells don't reach that far. Or can they? Oh, apparently yes. Hopefully they're jumping to friendly targets. I mean, to hostile targets and not to friendly targets such as this one. Although he's not going to help us fight. So, an Aloth. She's not going to run forward with that spell, is she? Well, either way, he's not positioned correctly for it. Let's have her run up and guard.
Eh?
I forgot to change her voice. Oh, she's got this weapon? Okay. Hey, hey! We're doing well. Ah, he's making a run around. Good, one down. Turning out much better. Excellent. You're a little late with that one. Much better than attacking them alone and at level 1. Looting time. Okay. So we got a hunting bow.
Yeah.
I'll let you do the honors. Leather armor, a cape, a hood, golden soul. I don't remember seeing that. The smallest gold coin used by the Valian Republics, the soul sun, is used for high value transactions. Awesome. Upgraded loot. I love upgraded loot. Okay, so yeah, I'm having this stuff hang out here. Can I just... I think there's a double click or something I can do. Okay. A dagger. Is that the stash? No. That's not the stash. Or is it? There's a stash. Okay, never mind. Hatchet. Small shield. Let's see if anyone can use a shield. I don't remember what we all have. Leather. Leather. Yeah, we're putting it in. Up. Silver fittings. Copper pans. And more drinky stuff. Okay. So she obviously has a shield. She has a shield. Okay. We don't need the shield. And neither does he. Pretty cool traps. Alright, let's talk to Tinfrith.
Hello.
By the flame, thank you. Thank you, thank you. I thought I'd be stuck cooking for these ignorant weasels for the rest of my life. Or until they were bored with me, I suppose. Did Pasca send you? She must be beside herself. I must get back at once. But listen, the next time you're in Gilded Vale, make sure to drop by the Black Hound. I'll let her know what you've done for me, and I'm sure she'll do right by you in turn. Oh, to be back at my oven again. Safe travels. And we got all kinds of goodies to plunder. Ooh, fruit. Plus 5 max endurance, 300 seconds. Deerwooden fruits include the imported sanreed, staple of Edirian orchards, and the common pear. The Valian figs are quite popular among the wealthy. Vegetables. A varied collection of celery, carrots, and other common vegetables. Plus 5 max endurance, plus 1 perception. 150 seconds. It must be the carrots, you know, giving you better sight or something like that. I don't know, guys. It just sounds good. Alright, it's like tab, right? Okay. The tent is empty, but for a pair of stained cots and the stink of unwashed bodies. Okay, we don't need that. Rice, meat, the glistening flesh of some unfortunate creature, plus 5 max endurance, plus 1 might, 150 seconds. Poultry, fowl, freshly plucked and ready for the pot. Well, they all have this plus 5 max endurance for, I think, 150 seconds, and plus 1 constitution for this guy. Oh, an agate. Cool. And some copper. Oh, I keep hitting the wrong thing. Sorry, guys. I'm so used to... I've been playing Whispered World and... what is it? The Book of Unwritten Tales, where you use the space bar to highlight items. So that's what's going on there. That's why I keep pausing. Oh, that was pretty awesome, though. Let's go save here. Oh, there's another thing you can do. You can make names for these save files now. So I can go like... Nice, huh? Alright, let's go change that character voice.
Well?
Yeah. I don't like the tone in your voice. Could it be this?
Huh? I'm here.
She seemed like a noble lady.
Quickly and quietly.
Feisty is the main character. We're gonna, you know, leave her for that.
Oh.
And she's not a...
Charge!
Not a mystic type.
Follow me.
So she's gonna be stoic. She'll always be stoic whenever possible, which will be... Always. Okay. We can't go that way. Oh, look at that. Yeah, that guy up there. We never did see that. We'll investigate that. Not sure how we get up. Are there stairs or something? Oh, there's a little area over here. Yeah. Oh, a young wolf? I know, I probably could have selected them all and go that way, but...
Eh?
Draw! Fire! Oh, there's another one. Okay, so you... Try to finish this guy off. Is this what I'm thinking of? Mind blades? We'll attack them. Harmlessly off the target, okay. Yeah. Oh, I forgot also we can zoom in. How do we move? Okay. I'm actually still learning stuff, guys. So we can see a little better this way. See that? Now, I'm not sure what I did with her. You know, the screen moves around way too much. I have to get used to that. Okay, she's still got that ability going, and, oh, they're gonna move up, right? It's for an area? I don't want, our fighter to walk into it. So we'll go this way.
Hi.
I'm not sure if he's even gonna hit him now. Nope. Oh, and you could have hit that other one too. Alright. Amplified thrust misses. Well, I didn't think there would be so many wolves. It's not hitting her, right? You gotta go way up to get her.
Yeah.
You seem to be doing alright. Oh, yeah. Actually, I don't want to waste any of his spells. Yeah. And these two are attacking, right? Let me just make sure, though. Run, wolfy friend! Awesome. Wolf hides.
No problem.
Not a problem. Much better than messing around in, Can I put this thing away? No, I... There's a way to drag stuff around, I don't know. Not sure if they have capes and cloaks. This is a regular hood, right? Yeah. We haven't exactly had a lot of money, so we weren't able to equip Firebrand correctly, but just not gonna get a patchwork of stuff going. Oh, that's pretty neat. Oh, it's purple too. Yeah, well, that's the scheme I chose. Duh. Okay. Oh, what we got there? These aged walls appear to have once encircled this entire glade. Only a small fragment remains, and the stairs leading to the top of the structure have crumbled away. Let's examine more closely. The heavy bricks are slick with moss, presenting a hindrance to climbing, but the stones themselves seem sturdy enough. Given the right tools, one might easily reach the top. Let's try to scale it just without the hook. See if we can do it. The crumbling wall is of a considerable height, even now, and its uneven surface promises a difficult climb. Who will scale it? Let's be smart and use the grappling hook. I don't know if we're going to injure ourselves falling. You give the grappling hook a few swings for momentum and let fly. And the hook lodges easily behind a pile of stones at the upper edge of the wall. A few tugs on the rope suggest that it will stay put. Alright. With the help of the rope, you make your way up the face of the wall and over the side. And here we are. Okay. Oh, we got stuff over here, too. A corpse. Ooh, camping supplies. Thank you. Added to supply count. Leather armor. Fulvano's gloves. Of reflex plus 5. Though never as famed as he would claim, the Valian explorer Fulvano was known as an eccentric who wished to see the world. Where possible, he traveled by foot to gain a local's appreciation for the sights, sounds, and smells of the lands he passed through. In practice, however, Fulvano often claimed that his explorations proved only that the world outside of the Valian Republics was a foul, smelly place that paled in comparison to his homeland. These gloves are said to have belonged to Fulvano, who often found himself in need of some protection as he climbed harsh terrain or maneuvered through forests. While thick enough to provide some warmth, they are meant first and foremost to be flexible enough not to hinder delicate tasks. Reflexes. Oh, a scrawled letter. I love scrawled letters. I do not think you will ever see this, but you were right, Fulvano. We should have journeyed south together and been safer for it. I would tolerate all the gloating in the world if I might live to hear it. I have put myself out of reach of the beasts circling below, but I am done for all the same. I do not think I will rise again. Whoever finds this, pray for me. Perhaps in the next life, I shall be a trapper of wolves. Oh, the wolves injured him badly enough. I can see blood to death. Interesting. I wonder if we'll run into this Fulvano. St. Grian's horn. I wonder if that's something that we have already. Maybe not. A favorite of hummingbirds, these large trumpet-shaped flowers are often found in gardens or used for decoration. 10 copper piece value. Alright, so who gets these? It's a mouse over, right? Dodging out of the way. Let's give that to our wizard. That's a good idea. How you feel about that? Awesome, or what? Gotta figure out how to use those traps at some point. Blood moss. We've seen that before, right? Good old blood moss. Yeah. Anyone wondering? Pause. Unpause. Okay. Done. From the edge of the wall, you can see an old cobblestone road turning south and the patchy trees of the Valewood. Your grappling hook and rope are still here, allowing for a relatively easy descent. You swing yourself over the side and pick your way back down to ground level. Cool. So, yeah, how do I get to that camp? That's what I wonder. Should I just run over there? And, I don't think we should tackle the bear. You know what I would like next for a party member? Cleric. Or priest, rather. I'm probably going to keep calling them clerics because I am a die-hard D&D adventurer, and I keep doing that, and there's nothing there. How do I get there? That's what I want to know. Up around this way. I can cross that. Ah! Is that someone fallen? Is that a body? Attack. No, they missed him. Alright, this could be a little hairy, possibly. I can't move that way? Where? You can't move? Alright, this way. He really can't move very much, can he? Okay. I want to get him in a good spot. Damaged one's hanging back. Wait, who we got here? That's Firebrand, right? Aloth is right in the way. What if we try to charm one of these things? What if we charm this guy? They're kind of like stuck, these guys. I'm having trouble with him. This is Aloth, right? He can't move. If we can't move him, well, that's a problem. Certainly a problem. I don't want to break the... Is it fighting itself? Yeah, yeah. See, I don't follow this, that I don't keep a hawk's eye on this. But it is attacking the Zorup. And I'm guessing it's this one. Yeah, green, friend. And foe. It's cast back already. It's back to being foe, so that didn't last very long. Fan of Flames, since he's got to be in the lead, since we can't move him.
Yes.
See if he can do it without it being interrupted. Awesome. Oh, look at that. We got Zorup Spears. Spears are not as long as their two-handed kin pikes, but they're easier to maneuver and can be used with a shield. Even with a one-handed grip, spears can strike fierce blows with high accuracy. This crude spear is decorated with feathers and beads, because it's a Zorup spear. And look, we got enchant right on the menu, like on the description, which I don't think was there before. I could be wrong. I could be right. And we got Zorup tongues, and we got all kinds of interesting stuff. Can I go like this? Oh, good. It's going into stash, right? Excellent. If you hold shift down, it'll automatically go to stash. Awesome. So, how about we sneak?
Shall be discreet.
No, yeah. All of us. Okay, a quarter staff. Can you take that? Silver fennings and a padded cap. The struts and supports are large enough to be the ribs and vertebrae of a dragon. Now I'm wondering about this stuff. A padded cap. Where do we get to see the stats on the caps here? Are all caps just caps? Is a helmet and a cap the same? It doesn't say anything about our defense here. So I have no idea if that's any better than an open helm, for example. I mean... it should be better. So what's he using now? Oh, wrong character. A scepter. So, speed is fast, 10 to 15 crush slash. Now we can see the differences right here. Speed is slow. 15 to... it hits harder. But it's slower. Let's have him hold on to it for now as a possible option. Well, faster is usually better. Ooh! Hidden object. Oh, would you look at this. A jasper, a turquoise, or two turquoises and two amethysts. Anything else to be found here? Can we go in? Is there, like, more to this, or is it just these huts? Nope, that appears like that's it. So when you know how to get somewhere, just point your cursor there and let's see where the party goes. Okay, so that's done. So apparently, with the exception of the bear cave, we've explored all of the Valewood. Interesting. Anyway. Next episode, it's back to Gilded Vale, and we'll collect our reward from the Black Hound Inn. And then, we're continuing on. I'm not sure what this is, this Kainua. Or if we should just head to Defiance Bay. Defiance Bay is closer, right? Madman Bridge. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time, and I'm trying to come up with another, a better, sign-off. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.